Recording again. All right, so number five, again, see the position. Again, the black king is hemmed in front of a rook pawn, and white king is not allowing him to escape. That's the key characteristics. So first move is knight to f6. Now, look at it. If black plays g5, right? We'll look at both. King h1 also we'll see it. But first let us look at knight g5. If knight to g5, then, pawn to g5, then knight to g4 check. Only move king to h1. And then king to f1. Now only move. There is only one move. h2. Knight to f2 is checkmate. Right? So let us go back and see what could have been different. So starting from the end, we will do it. G5, after this, knight to G4 check. After this, there was no possible deviations. Everything was forced after this. So let us say after, instead of G5, if he plays, what is the other move that he can play? He can play king H1, right? If king H1, then knight H4. Right? Knight h4. Now there are two moves. You can play h2 or you can play g5. So in both cases, we'll see. First, if you may move h2, then king f1. Now, still black has got only one move, which is g5, knight f2 checkmate. Okay? Okay, now what if some two moves back here, instead of h2, black plays g5. Not this, g5. Right, g5, then king h1, f1 again. Now, again knight has to come to, pawn has to move and then knight f2, right? So checkmate, forced checkmate. So I will just go back in and see if anyone wants to try out any this one. So knight f6 is the first move. Anyone? I think this is
lost.
It's lost, yeah. Right, this is lost, but it doesn't look apparent to just one move back, right? It looks very, very positive, but it is not. So, okay, so I think you enjoy this thing. Anyway, let's go to one very crucial end game, which is, okay, this is a crucial end game. Where now the knight is, there is one pawn each, the knight, you one side has a knight. So the idea of the white side is to use the knight to protect the pawn, his own pawn, allow the white king to go ahead and attack the black pawn and finally win the black pawn and then escort the white pawn to queening. That is the whole strategy, right? And black is trying to meddle with it. Black is somehow trying to win the white pawn. Okay, if black, even at the cost of his own pawn, if the white pawn is gone, then there is no checkmate, right? Then there is no checkmate. So black is trying to do it. So now there is a very, very crucial move here. Is only one move here which allows white to win, okay? Which is king to f3. Okay, we will see what happens if he moves other. Okay, but king f3, how first? Let us see what is the way to win. Black will try to come near the pawn, right? And king will come to g3. Now, black cannot kill the pawn. Black cannot move and further into the pawn. So, black king has to move here, right? So, this is the position where the knight makes the move. Now the black king is unable to approach the white pawn. Okay. And the knight has moved back. That is very crucial. Knight has to move back because black, if it tries to go back, then it will actually lose control over the support of his own pawn. So this is very, very crucial. Knight going back to h3. Now black king has to move somewhere. Now white king will come in contact with his pawn. And in such a way that the black king will now no longer be able to intrude. And now slowly after this,
Instead of king f6,
okay,
what is king to e5 better?
Yeah, king to e5 also it is similar. White king will come here.
And then king f6?
Yeah, king f6 it is fine. So now, I want to, yeah.
King g7?
King g7, okay. King G, now it is already the white has won the battle.
Oh.
Because once the white king has, see, once the white king gets into aggressive position, he will be able to bring his knight also in such a square and attack both the with the thing, and he will be able to win it. The only point that black had a chance, if it could get to h4 or g4, if black king could get to g4, okay, then it was attacking the knight also, it was attacking the pawn also, and it was making very life miserable. But now it is not. Okay, so let us first check the win part, and then we'll go back to see. So knight h3 we had seen, king f6. Okay, still, I mean, the king by going to e5, it makes the life a little bit more easier. But king to here, if it, again, it is similar, I mean, here, but knight to f2. Okay. Here, king f6. Now, it's opposition, and black king cannot go to g6. So, if it goes away, then knight comes here and denies even the f6 square. Right, already he cannot come to e5. So even if king goes here, right, this is, then white is ready to sacrifice the knight actually, because he will be very fast now. Black king, white king will kill the pawn, come to g7, and his pawn will run down. White is no longer bothered about the knight. So after this, if he plays something like this, white will very happily sacrifice the knight. Okay, because he is winning the battle there. So. So what is crucial here is that, okay, so let us see from the beginning what happens if instead of king f3, if white plays king g3. It looks very, very similar, but slightly different because of opposition, okay? So this is where the opposition comes into picture. So now black king comes to king to g5 with opposition. Now knight cannot move because the pawn will fall. King only has to move, and king has to now make way for the black king to come in. There is no way it can maintain. Even if it, either it has to lose h4 square or g4 square, right? So even if it doesn't want to lose g4, king will come to h4. Okay, now this is crucial. Now the knight cannot move now. Okay, and king is still not in contact with the pawn. So the knight cannot move. So now whatever white does, right, he is no longer now, he will not be able to do any progress. So he will try to come here. See, obviously, at this point of time, if white tries to sacrifice here, it doesn't work, okay? Because this is a well-known draw. How? King f7. Now, it's a rook pawn. So if the black king comes to h8, then it will become a draw, right? So black king, white king cannot come to h6.
Why can plays h8 in this move?
Yeah. So let us see it. Where are we? Here.
So right now, if king goes to h8, what happens?
So yeah, we'll see this. We'll see this. Okay. If king goes to h8, right? Okay, king, first of all, I'm seeing where are, I'm losing track of where am I. Okay, king h7, king f7. Okay, if h6, instead of h6, you are saying if king goes to h8, right? If king goes to h8, then black king also comes here.
So then white plays h6.
White plays h6, then black king comes here.
Okay. Now it'll be a stalemate for white.
Yeah. It will not be, yeah, it will be a stalemate. Yeah, it will become a stalemate. Black will force a stalemate. And if you don't want it, what else? You come here, then again black will come here. If you come out, then black gets in.
So, and then you lose because...
Then it's a draw.
So, because of the rook pawn.
Because of the rook pawn. Right? So let's go back. So at this point of time, see, black, by coming into g4, h4 and g5, right, it is getting some crucial squares, after which he is immobilizing the white. Okay, so that is the key part in this endgame. Because what else? Let us try here instead. So like we said, so king to g3 will allow king to g5, and now king h4. Now think of some moves, let us see. Want to try out anything?
King e4.
King e4 is what we said. King g4.
King e5.
King e5, and we said king g5.
Knight to g6.
Knight to?
g6.
g6, then this is finished.
Okay.
That's the key part. Knight cannot move.
Sir, but even after knight to g6, it will be a draw because...
it's a draw. But black is very happy with a draw. No? Black is not a problem.
King e6, I guess.
White is actually winning this game if you play properly. And black is only trying to draw.
Yeah.
So king e6.
King e6, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah, then that's what we saw. So king cannot go to e6. Knight cannot move, king cannot go to e6. King cannot come to f5 and f6. Yeah, so that's what the opposition is so crucial, actually, opposition, the concept of opposition. So that if we go back, so the key part here was, I even tried one more thing, okay. King to g3 allows the black king to come in with opposition. This is the key part to remember. But even if you try something else, right, what if you try... I think I have tried one more move.
What if you do king f3?
Yeah, what if knight comes here? Okay, I just tried this. Okay, forget about all these king moves and all. Okay, my idea is knight to e2. Well, after that, I don't want to go to f4. I want to go to g3 and support the pawn. And that is better because it is still backward. Knight, because see, the key point is that as long as the pawn is defended, black king cannot do anything. It will just hope. And the way it will hope is that it will try to attack both the knight. But the more behind the black, white knight is, that gives white opportunity to move the king and come and attack the pawn. Because the king, black king will be so much behind, right? That's the whole idea. But even this doesn't work. Okay, knight e2, king to g5. Knight to g3, king to g4 again. First of all, now the pawn is under attack. So there is only one move possible, which is knight to g3. Otherwise the pawn falls. And now king to g4.
Sir, I guess king to f3 is the first move.
So king to f3 in the original position is the only winning move in this. Okay, fine. All right. So since we are anyway continuing the session, why not I finish the bishop endgames also? Try as much of it. Okay. Are you guys okay?
Yes, sir.
Let's go ahead.
Yes, sir.
See, bishop, the good part is that because it can move any number of squares on the diagonal, right? So there are some many advantages to bishop in the end game. Okay, so now you see a single bishop against three pawns, it is still able to defend against all the three pawns. Anyway, white cannot hope to win, only black can hope to win. But in this position, white can defend and white can draw. Okay, because all the pawns are, I mean, the key squares where they will advance are blocked by the bishop along a single diagonal. Okay, however, you still have to be careful. There is only some moves that you can make, but those are forced draws. So what would you play? Okay, let me first demonstrate how it is to play. King to f4 is a crucial move. Now try to play anything for black, because white has got a dark square blockade now, and that is the key part. It will not allow the movement along the dark squares.
e5 check, then bishop takes.
e5, then very trivial.
Bishop cannot.
Bishop will take it, right? e5 will, bishop will take it and again go back again. So it cannot, right?
King c5
is the only attempt. And then now here, there are two ways that you can do it. King e5 also can do it, but king d4 is more thematic. It will show you what is the thing. So now e pawn cannot move and d pawn also cannot move, right? If d5 to d4, then also bishop takes it. If e6 to e5, then also bishop takes it. And if king goes back, yeah. So king c4, then bishop to d4. Okay. Now king to b3. King will try to go to here and try to make some. He will try to come to b1. Okay, and then queen the pawn and then get the bishop thing, and then he will try to win. But king to d2.
So how do you stop all the pawns?
See, you have stopped, right? White has stopped all the pawns.
But you have to take them.
So the black king is forced by the bishop and the king.
Yeah. No, now I'll give you a chance. No matter what, how, whatever you try to move the pawn, you will not succeed.
What if black just moves the king for the rest of the game?
Yeah, then after...
It will be a draw, that's the point.
It will be a draw, right? After 50 moves.
Okay. So how will it be a draw after 50 moves?
If no pawn has moved or no piece has been captured for 50 moves, then it's a draw.
Oh, okay, sir. So I thought it was only king is left on the board.
No. You read the rules properly. No pawn has moved and no capture has been done for 50 moves consecutively, then it's a draw. So here what happens is the moment the pawn moves, it will get captured. That's the key part. And so you do not dare move the pawns. And if you move the pawn, that pawn will go. Again, the other two pawns again cannot move. So there is no way. But it's not so easy as you think. Huh? So it is not so. So here instead, you think that, okay, if you move king to f6 here, okay, now also you think that e5 cannot move because bishop will take it. d5 to d4 cannot move, but this is a loss. If you play king to f6, then black wins this.
How?
Black wins this. How? Still e5. You take it. King to c5. Now he's going to play d4.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, because your king is too far away from the pawn.
Bishop goes back, then also it doesn't help now because d4. Okay. King to e5. d3. Now, bishop to c3 is forced. Then?
But then d2 anyways.
Okay. Or instead of d2, white, after bishop to c3, white, black could queen, then play d2.
Yeah, but it is better, cleaner this way. I'll show you in the next example. So, next example, I will show you why it is better this way. But it's okay. In this position, it is okay. But it is much better to queen with a check and everything, right? So here, just go back and see. If king to f6, then e5, bishop takes e5, king to c5. Try to see if you can find a way to defend.
King
f5. King f5. D4.
Ah, you're threatening to queen.
Yeah. So you are forced to give up the bishop now. So you cannot actually here, you cannot but go back to this. But even after going back, I play d4. Now, you try as much to come, but d3. Now, if you delay it, if you don't play bishop to c3, then the d2, and then you cannot stop the pawn. So bishop to c3 is forced. And now d2. Right? So one thing to remember in these things, one rule to remember is that whenever you are trying to defend against two connected pawns using your bishop and king, right? You should be in front of the pawns, okay? And your bishop should attack from one side and the king should attack from the other side, like this, okay? So that is the way that you can, okay? Not something like this or wherever it is. So here, you are trying to defend against this pawn. So bishop is attacking from here, so you know that. And this is your crucial spot, e5. So your king has to come to f4, okay? Remember, so they are like, cross purposes they are controlling. That is the right way. There are a lot more deep examples are there of study, but which will demonstrate, but this is the general principle that you can follow. Okay, king to f4, you are not at cross, you are not acting like a cross against the pawn, you are trying to go behind the pawn, and that doesn't work. But king to f4, that's right. If you remember this, then generally it will be right if you follow this. Okay, now we will see the bishop is very powerful when there is only one diagonal. But again, like we saw in the thing, when it has to defend against two diagonals, then it will be very difficult for it. Okay, so in this position, what is the right move? D2 or A3?
Wait, sir, it says D2 gives up the win, but how?
Yeah, so
oh, A3 because, is the right move. Because when bishop takes, it's jack.
Yeah, it's d2. I'll show you. See, A3 is the right move because after this, the queen happens and then game is finished. But if you think that, oh, both of them are similar, d2 if you play, then d2 if you play, then obviously bishop has to take it. Right?
Difference is bishop takes it with check.
Not so much as the check is not the big thing, but it allows the white king to come to c4. And now the pawn can be stopped by the white king. Now, what do you do? Now the a pawn is not queening. If you play a3, king b3, finished. And if you don't play a3, then also it is finished. If you try to support with the kong, then also it is finished. So giving up the d2 pawn was not the right thing for black. It is not so much of a check, but it is about where the pawns are and whether they can be queened. Right? Yeah, d2 is a blunder, obvious. Yes, d2 is a double question mark. So a3 is the right thing, which is very clear. Now, anyway, you have to kill the pawn. You can't not kill the pawn, right? And then, okay, you can wait. You can wait like this, but then a2. And now, after this, now d2, you can play it. Now d2 is okay. Okay, next move, d2 is okay. Because now the pawn is going to queen, but earlier it was not. If the king was away, yes, you are right. Madhura is asking, if the white king was away, then d2 would have been okay. Yes, it depends on that. But if white king was further away, let us say one square further away, then d2 would have also won. Okay, but these are all crucial matters. So try to be played safer and surer way, which is clearer way. Okay. All right. Then there is one interesting, very interesting thing where against three connected pawns also black, white single bishop is able to defend. I will not go through it. I have put all the comments and everything in the study. You can go through it. Okay. I will try to finish the thing. This position again, I think you already know it. It is a wrong colored bishop. The white pawn is going to queen on the h8 square, which is a dark square. And if the bishop is not dark square, then already black king has reached it. Then you will not be able to evict the king from the h8 square. And hence it's a draw. It will become a stalemate draw. I think I've shown this multiple times earlier, I think in level 1 or level 2 or some things. So
there's one more stalemate. King g6.
King g6 would already be a stalemate, but h6, even if you play, king h7. Now, bishop g6, king g8, king g. After this, again, it's a stalemate. You cannot evict the king. See, the key part is, king has already reached the corner square. See, first thing is that it is a rook pawn. Then only this draw is possible. If it is a rook pawn and the opponent king has already occupied the queening square, you have to evict him from there. And with the bishop of the right color only, you can evict. If the wrong color, you cannot evict. That is the principle, right? Go through it, no problem. Now we will see, try to see a similar position where it is now. What is the position? Black is trying to win by queening the pawn, and white is, again, the bishop is of the wrong color, right? Bishop is of light square, while the queening square will be, queening square is dark. However, key position difference, this white is not able to hold this. White will lose this game because the king is away. It has not reached the queening square, which is a1 in this case, and black is going to prevent him from coming. It's a very instructive endgame. Very instructive endgame. Okay, let us see how black prevents. Even though there is a wrong colored bishop, still black wins this. Okay, he starts by playing bishop to f5, right? Controlling the b1 square, b1, c2 square. So obviously, white king is in a hurry to come to a1. If white king reaches a1, then that's it. Then there is a draw, right? But black king is trying to prevent him from coming to a1. Okay, so king. Now, what will you do? If you play king to c1 here, then black also again comes here. See, now the black king cannot come approach the a1 square because b1 is also gone and b2 is also not in line for him, right? So after this, it's a draw. Even if you
would it be zugzwang if white pushes the pawn?
No, because white king comes here.
What if white pushes again?
Then again, I will demonstrate. Not taking the pawn. Taking the pawn will be wrong. Comes here. Mm-hmm. Taking the pawn, the king, white king will come to b1, and after that it will come to a1. So black is not in a hurry to take the pawn. Now even if you queen the pawn, it doesn't matter. So that is, in fact, that is the, by alternation, that is what it comes in the thing. So
the white king can't go on b1.
White king, where will it go?
On the b1 square.
Yeah, it cannot go.
Yeah, so black can win this, right?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Black is winning this game. That's what I'm saying. White is trying to draw, but not able to draw.
Okay.
So let's go back here. Again, similarly, here after king to d4. Now, king to c1, king to c3, and black prevents him. Even if he plays c6, then also king to c4.
Wait, so I have a question. So can you move back to that position earlier? So no, sir, what you were showing before.
Okay, not this. You are saying king to c1, then king to c3.
Yes, sir. Then, no, sir, when the pawn was on c7, so that position.
Okay, fine, here.
King, so yes, then.
Yeah, king to a2 is the very correct move here. Not okay. King takes. Okay. Now?
So, because if king wasn't on king a2, so then I know the best counter for white.
Yeah, obviously. But that is why the king has come to a2 and not taken the pawn. Right? Because otherwise you are trying to make the queen, then the bishop will be diverted, and with that diversion you will come to b1. Once you come to b1, you will definitely come to a1, and then it's a draw. So that is what black is preventing. Okay, same thing in the main line also, same thing here. Instead of king to c1, even if you play c6, then also king to c4, c7, king to a3. Okay, now king to, obviously you want to play c8, bishop c8, and then, but so you want to be in time to reach b1, but again king comes to a2. That's it.
If so king, why can't you take the pawn?
Why can't you take the pawn? So if, yeah, let us see, if king takes a3, then c8, queen, you have to take it, king b1. Now even if you give a check, doesn't matter, I am coming to a1. That's it. After I come to a1, it is my, I am, that's it. No matter what you try now. Now you cannot evict me from a1. Try any move.
Only b, queen b3.
King b3. King b3 is a stalemate, right?
No.
So you will have to play king to b4. King to b4, I play king to b2.
A2, a3 check.
A3 check. Then I play king to?
Bishop to e6.
Bishop to e6, I come to here.
King to b3.
King to b3.
Oh, wait. King to b3 is stalemate.
No, king to b3 is not stalemate. I can come to b1. King to b1.
King to c3.
King to c3. King to a1.
Pawn to a2. Oh, sorry. This is
stalemate.
So it's always gonna be a stalemate.
Yeah, the moment I reach, see, the moment I reach, the, it's a rook pawn. Okay, you have only a bishop. You don't have a rook. Black bishop is there, and I have come in front of the pawn on the queening square. That's it. It's a draw. Very simple draw. Yeah, you may still make mistakes, so please practice it. But it's a draw. Yeah, stalemate is a draw, so it is. Okay, how much time is there? Let me see. 10:36, how many minutes are left?
So 4 minutes are left, 4 minutes, 40 seconds.
Okay, then I think we will not be able to. I will just do a very simple. Okay, these two, number 13 and 14, you can look through it. But again, this is, who, first of all, let us identify who is trying to win, who is trying to lose. What is this position, first of all?
Nobody will try to lose.
No. yeah, you are right. Nobody is trying to, but who can win and who can, who is trying to draw and who is trying to win?
Black is trying to win and black and white is trying to draw.
Yeah, white, obviously, unless black makes some very big mistakes, white is hoping to only draw, okay? Black has chances of win. So how it goes about it, let us see it. Bishop to, first of all, very important, bishop to g3. Okay.
G4.
Sorry, bishop to g4. Now, king to h4 and not taking the pawn. Taking the pawn is a big mistake. Why? What was I saying? Okay, king to f4 is also a mistake. Yeah. forget taking the pawn. King has to go to e6, but even if king comes to f4, then you play g3. Okay, now if you take it the pawn, then also it's a stalemate. No, it's not a stalemate. G6, it will be a draw because bishop will be diverted to stop the pawn, and then white king will take the pawn. So this is what will happen. So black will not be able to win this. Okay, black will not be able to win this. And if you simply block it, if you don't take the pawn and if you block it, then it's a stalemate. No, then also it is not a stalemate, but again, this will happen. Okay, I think, wait, I have to show. So let me show the win first and then come back to this, okay? So king to e6, black plays by forcing a zugzwang. So white comes back, black comes and supports the pawn first, and now no matter what happens, bishop is going to control, not allow the pawns to move ahead. Okay, I think we don't have enough time to go through it. Let us see it in the next class. Okay, this and the next one. There are two complicated examples. It will take some time to go through it. But the key part is again the blockade by the bishop along the light squares here, right? With king supporting the pawn and then forcing the zugzwang. That is the idea. Let us see it in the next class. Okay. All right. I will stop the recording.